Good evening, Mr. Chairman, members of the board, Mr. Town Manager. My name is Steve Ells, and I appear this evening on behalf of Al Fleury, who is with me, and you all know. Al is the owner and the operator of Wally's, of Bernie's Beach Bar, and The Goat down at the beach. And he's, as indicated by the chairman in the notice, asking the board to reconsider its current policy on serving food after 1 o'clock. Al is now considering establishing yet another business at the beach, which would not be involved with the sale of alcohol. It would be a food restaurant. And he would like the board to consider a rethinking of the policy regarding no food sales between 1 and 5 a.m. As indicated when we had our first meeting with the board, we researched this issue, and the only restriction on those food sales for those hours was the Hampton Code Chapter 737, which prohibits any eating establishment from serving food between 1 and 5 a.m. That ordinance also prohibits the sale of alcohol. And as it was established in 1970, I think perhaps a lot of the motivation for that ordinance had to do with restricting alcohol. I wasn't of legal age in the late 60s, early 70s, but it seems to me that was about the time when Hampton went from a dry town to some of the more mature members present might remember the exact date, but I got to believe that a lot of the ordinance was aimed at alcohol rather than food. But that's what the ordinance is and has been since 1970. Again, we pointed out at our initial meeting that ordinance was enacted pursuant to RSA 105:6, which very clearly then gave the Hampton Police the authority to regulate the time that a restaurant, they called them eating houses or restaurants, would be open. And as a result of the police determining those times, the then Board of Selectmen, pursuant to statute, enacted that as an ordinance. That's been our policy in the town in the business seasonal zone only since 1970. We found that in 1993, the state legislature amended RSA 105 to eliminate from the police the authority to establish hours for operation of eating houses. I'm not sure that voids your ordinance, but I think at the very least it calls its enforceability into question. And it seemed appropriate for us to approach the board and bring this to the board's attention and inquire as to whether or not you'd be willing to try something different in terms of food sales between 1 and 5. Again, Al's proposal, his plan, is to serve for an hour or two past 1 o'clock, so to perhaps 2 or 3 o'clock in the morning. No alcohol of any kind. His facility won't even have a liquor license, so there'll be no alcohol enforcement issues at all. We've kind of referred over and over to the Gillies restaurant in Portsmouth as kind of a role model, a place where you can go at the end of an evening of perhaps drinking, have something to eat on your way home. And Al thinks there's a need for that. Other towns allow for it. He tells me that his patrons leave his establishments and go to other towns to get something to eat rather than walking across the street to a local place. We feel that society and the beach has been changed drastically since 1970, and We think that extending the hours for sale of food at the beach, and we're really just talking about the summer months, as you all know. I don't think anybody cares a whole lot what goes on down there in February and March. There's not a whole lot of folks down there. We're talking about the summer months, obviously. We don't think it would be a bad idea. In fact, we think it would be consistent with what's been going on for the last several years with the what we call the revitalization of the beach. And it's a commercial beach. It's a destination beach. Recognize that families still go there, which is all good, but I think there's perhaps room for everybody. And I'll just close by saying, rather than just opening a facility and starting to serve after 1 o'clock, getting cited by the police, and then going to court and fighting about it, Al said that's not any way he wants to do business. He felt we really needed to come to this board, start the conversation, and that's what we're doing. And we appreciate the time and effort the board is put into it. And we look forward to hearing from the other members of the community this evening. Thank you.
Okay. You want?
You got it.
I'm all for it.
He's the guy.
Kay, is there anybody from the public that would like to get up and speak?
I would like to ask. He said, keep saying 1 to 5. But I thought it was to 3 o'clock.
The current ordinance says no sale of food from 1 to 5. Al is proposing to extend that 1 o'clock deadline by 1 or 2 hours. He's not saying all night. He's saying maybe 2 o'clock, maybe 3 o'clock. Your ordinance now says no food sales 1 to 5. But he's not saying 1 to 5. He's saying maybe 2, maybe 3.
I'm not looking to do anything that extensive. The reason I'll throw one thing in is that I've been at Wally since 2004, and we've always been the last stop. Everybody thinks that Christie's Pizza is open till 1. It's not. Everybody thinks that Wally's is open till 1. We may be able to do slices of pizza, and the only reason we do that is to try to be, you know, responsible. And these days, in the heart of the summer, we try to keep our kitchens open as late as possible. At the Goat, Wally's, and Bernie's, we have a late night menu, and we try to push it as late as possible. We keep our staff on right to the end of the night, but with the amount of people that you see on a Saturday night is obviously when your crowds come. It's really hard to physically stand and eat when it's in a crowded bar, and it's taking away from my business of, you know, keeping, you know, entertaining the crowd and keeping everything moving. To try to sell full meals with a full house is tough. So still, we are still the latest place serving on the beach. So that said, the reason I think that the 3 a.m. number works for us is I could happily close my kitchens at 11 and try to, you know, move people in that direction, and it gives, you know, the students and the people and the workers that work there. I mean, I know when I'm fully staffed in the summertime, like, we have a staff of about 250 employees between my three businesses, all working on the beach. On a busy Saturday night in the summer, it takes me about 75 to staff Bernie's, 30 at Wally's, I don't know, maybe half that at the Goat. So just me, not everybody else who has restaurants and or the ballroom lets out or whatever the case is, I think you'd be surprised at the amount of people that are working on the beach. I think it's in the thousands. And I know that it's in the thousands of patrons that get out at 1 o'clock. And so I'm completely aware that, you know, alcohol and food, the way that it works is that the food that you consume before you drink alcohol is what tends to sober you up. But I think if we can offer at 11 when nobody else offers at 11 and we still serve food until 1 o'clock, that can help sober people up in a completely different perspective of just trying to serve the, you know, the J1 kids that have, who are great college students that work literally 3 jobs. They'll work at a hotel. Some of the guys behind me, I've seen, you know, they have a lot of J1 students. They run the hotel. They clean all morning. They'll work a day job, and then they'll come and they'll work for me in the kitchen to help close. And they will literally sleep 6 hours, but there's nowhere for them to eat. So they'll drive to Salisbury, which allows after 1 a.m. food service, or Portsmouth, that allows after 1, or Seabrook. All of our neighbors allow after 1 a.m. service. And I'm sure the reason they are, Seabrook's obviously growing. Portsmouth is the, you know, the goal here. You know, for all of, they do a great restaurant business and tourism business. And I think that we can achieve to, you know, get to there, because no, we're not a city. And maybe I just heard that mentioned, but I believe that we are worthy of city rules in the summertime. We have 100,000 person people any given day on the beach. And we may only have whatever, 15, 16,000 in the wintertime or on a day like today. But I think that we need to treat the crowds like they're here on vacation. They came here. They should be, I don't know, they should have everything that can be offered should be offered. And the staff and the people and the hardworking people that I employ and everybody else employs should get a chance to, you know, catch a break and work a hard day and make a bunch of money and be able to eat something before they have to drive home or wake up early the next morning and do it again. So that's it.
Okay, thank you. Public comment from the people in the audience. Come to the mic and let us know where you are, your name and your address, please.
Chuck Rage, 121 Ocean Boulevard. I'm speaking as the chairman of the Village District and then as a business owner at the beach. Everybody knows that I am for helping businesses down in Hampton Beach. I'm at every meeting that people need help with at the beach, not just the businesses, but I also represent the residents of the Village District, the cottage owners of the Village District, the hotel owners of the Village District. And one of the issues, I came here in the early 80s, and I remember the beach before Chief Sullivan and Chief Sawyer, before they were here, we had a huge cruising issue. And at 2, 3, 4 in the morning, the beach was still hopping. And unfortunately, it was keeping up people in the hotel. We had a bad rep in hotels, in cottages, houses, residents. We had a bad reputation of the beach being a little crazy. If we want to become a New Orleans or a Las Vegas, which would be a very small likeness, but then we're open late. And I think right now when Chief Sawyer goes out with his men, and they're stretched with the amount of offices they have, and they can say to someone, nothing is open. Why are you out here at 2 in the morning? Go home. And that's what they do. I see it. I'm out on my property, keeping an eye on my property. I'm the first that would love to go out and have a meal after I've been out a night on the town. But I'm telling you, for Hampton Beach, I've gotten 10 calls against this to 1-4. And the reason being is the staff leaving the bars now are going. They're going to their cars. They're making noise. They're causing commotion. People walking down the street are causing commotion. So the nice little old lady on a leaded street can't go to sleep. And then she's got her trash barrels at 5:30 in the morning being picked up. So I think that we need to keep it a family beach, keep it quiet. And I think is I just don't think it's right for Hampton. And I've heard a lot of things that at Gillies, is it Gillies or Gillies, you know, Gillies, that they have a lot of incidents late at night. When you have people hanging around and they're coming out of bars, they're gonna cause problems. So I think 1 o'clock is a great time. I think the concept of a family diner is fantastic. And I would support that. I send a lot of people to your restaurants. I support all the businesses at the beach, but I also support the reality that we want to keep it a family beach. Thanks.
Okay. Next.
Brian Lapham, 27 I Street. I can't say I'm in favor of this because I lived through this in Salisbury. They tried to keep places open late to serve their patrons and what have you. I commend you for trying to take care of your own employees, but I live at the end of I Street, and At 1 o'clock, I can guarantee you cruisers are flying down there. I also know there's a setup. I mean, to actually go down there and meet to make sure everything is correct. One of the biggest problems we had was people that had ordered their last drink, and, well, no, you're not going to take that away. So now might be 2 o'clock before they had their last drink. When last call is supposed to be at, I believe, 12:30, all liquor removed by 1. That's the rules in several towns. But anyway, I just can't see this, because it's going to leave people out there now till 2 or 3 o'clock in the morning, walking around, getting into mischief, and we already have enough. So please keep it to Hampton Town, and I don't think we're ready for this. Thank you.
Thank you. Anybody else?
Bob Ladd, 7 Cutler Avenue, Village District Commissioner. I, too, support what the previous two speakers have said. You're placed in the unenviable position of trying to decide between two legitimate opposite sides. Many of the people who aren't here tonight can't be here. They don't live here. They rent here in the summer, or they own seasonal cottages, or they're in Florida if they're fortunate enough. But they, too, have a dog in this fight, and they have to be represented. And it's a balancing act. And I don't see how one restaurant can be open from 1 to 3 without every other food servicing venue on the beach being open from 1 to 3, which merely keeps the beach at a level of activity which would prohibit reasonable, you know, time to sleep for the people who are renting homes and cottages and hotel and motel units at the beach during those time frames. So I, for those reasons, I just think if we err, we should err on the side of the residents having some quiet time during the night, or at least place this issue in the form of a warrant article or referendum and let the town decide whether it wants to push this out to 3 a.m., 2 a.m., or 5 a.m. Thank you.
Good evening. My name is James Scully. I live at 434 High Street. I want to thank you for the opportunity and privilege to speak this evening. I currently reside on High Street. However, I am currently in the process of closing on a property in this Hampton Beach Village District. I plan on permanently residing there and hopefully someday raising a family there. Hampton Beach has been a part of my life since childhood. I began lifeguarding on Hampton Beach when I was 16 years old. After departing military service, I came and worked for the town part-time. And later, I worked with Mr. Fleury in the restaurant business. With that being said, I have seen Hampton Beach through a variety of lenses, and I'd like to offer my opinion this evening. As we all know, the New Hampshire seacoast is a destination for people from all over. With that, Hampton sees a dramatic influx of people during the summer months. With this increase of people, it is obvious that there will be more activity in the beach area. I seem to think that the benefits of this proposal is twofold. First off, it will continue to drive business in the beach area, and secondly, it will undoubtedly allow people who likely should never get behind the wheel a place to go and eat before they do so. The first of these reasons, however, is what I find most important for the town. The beach has a wide array of people who come to the summer and work. Many of these people work 2 to 3 jobs just to get by. And they do not stop working until the beach shuts down currently at 1 a.m. This new establishment would allow these people to get something to eat. Additionally, the surrounding communities such as Portsmouth, Seabrook, and Salisbury all allow for some sort of late night dining. And I see a detriment for our beach community to not do the same. The beach area is a tourist destination, and people save all year round to come to Hampton on vacation. I see no reason why we as a town cannot afford our residents and also the tourists that come here a place to dine after 1 a.m. Every vacation destination I go to has something of this same nature. And quite frankly, I take pride in Hampton. And I take pride that Hampton is a fantastic tourist destination. And I do not know why we as a community would not want to allow something like this for our residents and tourists. Thank you for your time.
Thank you.
Bob Preston, 339 Ocean. I want to say to Al how much we appreciate the investment that he's put into the beach and his businesses. It's been a nice addition to what he's doing, and I think we're fortunate to have that. But in this particular thing, I want to say that I'm against it. I'm against it for several reasons. I rent some properties around Wally's and the Goat, and, you know, I get noise complaints and stuff, and I tell the people, I say, you know, you rented there. We know what's there. We're going to have music. The people are going to have fun. But it stops at a certain time, and that generally works. Right? Now, I'm not against Al doing this per se. I'm against everybody else having the opportunity, because as soon as you do it with one, then we're going to have the pizza people up in the front, or we're going to have, we'll just say blanks, we'll just, everybody that has a big tax bill or a big rent is going to want to extend that those hours if they possibly can. And I think once that happens, we lose the ability for our police department to sweep the beach, to get everybody going. Because once they get people going, then Public Works can come in and start cleaning up the beach. I just don't think it's good for our family business, a family beach that we have here. People coming back to the cottages, they come back now at 1, they're full of fun, they're talking, they're loud. I don't need them coming back to my places at 2:30 in the morning, you know, after they've had, you know, some more fun. So I prefer that we shut down the beach at 1 o'clock. I think it's better for us in the long run. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Pam Panarelli. I live on 25 K Street. I know you guys couldn't hear everybody, so I'm going to kind of turn. I work for the town. I work in the school department. I have to get up at 6 o'clock every morning to go to work. I live right on K Street, right in the mix of all of this. And I'm having a hard time thinking that 3-4 o'clock in the morning is when I'm going to get to bed, knowing I have to get up 2 hours later. Hampton is a destination place, but as a resident and an owner and a taxpayer, I think I have as much rights as people that come in to visit our town. And to take that away by making, I just think it's going to be the Wild West. I can't picture anything good coming out of that being so late. My grandparents always told me, nothing good happens after midnight. You got to get home. I just feel, and I've been in the restaurant business myself 30 years, and I do go to Al's places, and I think Al's a great guy and everything, but I just don't think this is the spot, this is the place, this is the time for this, if we were going to keep it as a residential community, because it is. I know a lot of these people in here live there. They're not just here for the weekend and then screwing out of there. They're here and they love it here. Don't take that away from us. Please don't take that away from us. Let us have our own house and be able to have our grandchildren and children sleep. I mean, I know you wouldn't want it in your neighborhood. You probably wouldn't want it behind you, next door to you. Maybe that's why you don't live at the beach. But I worked my whole life to get a house at the beach, and here I am, and now I don't want it taken away and ruined because I have to have motorcycles and people walking back and right in front of my house or trying to cut through the yards and stuff. 3-4 o'clock in the morning. I just don't think that's fair to the residents and all the other people that live and stay there. I'm sure they don't want it if their families are with them. Thank you for your time. I think you do a great job at all your other places. I do appreciate everything you do for the town. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Joel Vaca. I live at 124 Kings Highway, but I lived three doors down from Wally's for several years. I'm in full support of this. I think it would be awesome to be able to get out of work. I've worked on that beach for 15 years in the bar business. I worked for Al for a brief period of time. It would be nice to be able to get out of work after a 13, 14-hour day and be able to sit and have a meal. I think, you know, the reason why people move to that beach is because it's a very upbeat, fun destination. It is, I'm speaking more for the younger generation, but we're going to be the ones that are here for that. The older people that don't want it, the reality is, it's the younger people that are going to be here going forward. So I think, you know, that's what we want, and I'm in full support of it. Thanks.
Thank you.
It was the older people talking with the guppy. I just, Maureen Buckley, Hampton Beach Village District Commissioner. The woman who spoke about living on Ashworth, or K Street rather, was absolutely right. I've gotten phone calls from people who are on Ashworth, and the gentleman who also spoke about wanting to raise a family, I'm sure he does not want to raise it across from there. It's difficult. Again, I'm not against you, Al, either. But the bottom line is, it's loud at 1 o'clock. Everybody who lives in that area can tell you when the bars are getting out. It's outrageous. I don't think that people should be have to expose themselves to 3 o'clock in the morning as well. 1 o'clock is late enough. We are a family beach. That doesn't speak to family. And please, please, don't allow this to happen. We live on the beach. The people that spoke, we live there. We know what it's like at 1 o'clock in the morning. Please don't make us wait till 3 to get to bed. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Tom Matheny. I live at 2A Bragg Ave. Lifelong resident of Hampton. I do work for Al. I run all his kitchens. And I guess I'm one of the old people, but I'm all for this. We're not talking about thousands of people hanging out at a place that's going to hold 50 people. We're not talking about tons of traffic. It's just not going to generate it. You're talking 50 seats, people getting something to eat. I myself have 40 J1 students that work for us that work three jobs, like Al said, get out at 1 o'clock, 2 o'clock in the morning doing dishes, do not have transportation, cannot get anything to eat anywhere, go anywhere, because they walk to their housing, they go to work the next day. There's no options for them whatsoever. I did 9 winters in Pompano Beach, Florida, resort town, similar to Hampton. We all had places we could go 24 hours. We could go out to any number of diners that are open 24 hours, get something to eat with coworkers, sit and talk about your day, like you guys getting out at 5 o'clock. Many options. Us people in the restaurant business, we get out at 1:30, 2 o'clock, some of us, and we don't have any options. There's just nowhere to go. But if I could open a diner uptown Hampton, it's all one town. That's legal. There's no rules against it. It used to be a place called the Nifty Fifties. I've worked for Al. I don't believe we'd have any what they want to call problems, and we would extend. Bouncers would be there. We would take care of it. Al takes care of everything that he does. We're here for the long run. Al's a great businessman, spent a lot of money in town. And what kind of somebody else may be coming to this town to invest on the beach? Al spent a lot of money here. We're not trying to do something illegal. We're trying to sell food. It's not like there's nothing shady going on. It's a burger, some breakfast. And we're talking 50, 60 people at most. That's all that's going to fit in this place. So I don't see where there'd be a great deal of traffic. I think the biggest part of our business would be people grabbing something to go and still going home at that 1:30. There's 50 seats. That's about all we're going to hold. So, I mean, I'm all for this. I think a lot of things have changed in Hampton. I've been here since 1961, worked at the beach most of my life. Started digging sea worms for Al Gore when I was 9. So it's not 1970 anymore. It's a resort community with people should have options. Even if you're just grabbing something to eat to go back to your motel room with, there is no options like that right now. The second it hits 1 o'clock, even though we have till 1:30 to clear our buildings, which all the bars in Hampton do, they can't get food after 1 minute after 1. But they could leave now grab something to eat, take it back to their hotel rooms, take it back to their cottage where they can still spend some time with some friends quietly in their own house. But I just don't see a great deal of traffic and problems being generated out of one small business. Thank you.
Selectman, thank you. John Kane, 115 Ocean Boulevard, right in the heart of Hampton Beach across from the playground. Been on the beach since 1961. I thought it was the gentleman over there, the same age as I am. I've run a fast food place. I rent out the fast food places. I stay up at night trying to protect my property. Al's done a great job. Bernie's is great. You know, goat's great, everything like that. Not a problem with you. However, this isn't just going to be one place. I can tell you, it's just like the frozen yogurt that we had up at the beach. They opened up, they hit it really good, and next year we had five that were open. So if we extend it to Al, you're going to have to extend it to every business on Ocean Boulevard or at the beach. And that means basically, you know, you have bouncers, but some of these fast food places don't have bouncers. And what you have is you have a lot of people who have been out, I'm not going to say all drunk, but, having a good time. Some of them, maybe out of control a little bit. And when you have groups of like those people coming together, that is when you're going to have problems with the police. And Hampton Beach has changed. Over the last 10 years, the infrastructure at Hampton Beach, what the state's done, what the town has done, we've thrown in hundreds of millions of dollars. Mr. Preston was up here. He's a reflection of what's going on at the beach. He just bought a condo. Those condos are going for $500,000. And these are people that have to get up in the morning. I am now retired, but I used to be a financial advisor for Merrill Lynch and would have to get up at 5:30 in the morning in order to get to my office in Lexington. My wife is a trustee, works in downtown Boston. She gets up and she is out of the house by 5:30 to get a bus to go into Boston so that she can be in Boston by 8 o'clock. There are a lot of people down the beach that, are homeowners, and we're seeing more and more people that are coming down the beach that are homeowners, and they're having to pay for those mortgages, and they're still working, just like the lady in the back on K Street. She's got to get up in the morning. We all got to get up in the morning. And now what you have is you have the police with some kind of authority and saying, nothing's open, go home. As a kid, I can remember them going down Ocean Boulevard. The beach is closed, and they would put a spotlight on the people on the beach, actually walking, go home. And they basically just herd them out. The police have been doing a great job, but if we extend that out, it's going to cost us more in taxes because we're going to have more patrolmen out there longer. The other thing that happens is that now you've got a problem with that we've kind of come away from is like what happens after 1 o'clock when they want to go to the bathroom. Now my backyard becomes a urinal again. The state closes down. Everyone gets a little bit of a break, a reprieve. We clean up the streets. The street cleaners are out there. If we all push this back a couple more hours, we're not going to have enough time to take care to get ready for the next day. And there's a lot of people that spend a lot of money to come down to Hampton Beach. The Pelham Suites, the Ashworth. It's $375 a night. Those people want to go to bed, they want to get up, and they want to go to the beach. Mr. Welsh, I believe you come through Hampton Beach in the morning. During the summertime, you will see those beach chairs out there at 7 a.m. They are reserving the spots. They'll go home and get a coffee, but they're all out there. You see a lot of parents out there walking their children out there. It's a family resort. We've made it a family resort, and I would like to keep it that way. I talk to thousands and thousands of people through the website that we have, HamptonBeach.org. And basically, they like the changes that, we've all made to make, the beach a better beach to come to and live and play and vacation. And, I just think, again, keeping that open until 2, 3 o'clock in the morning is going to be, you know, it's going to hurt our police. The fire's probably going to get more calls, so they're going to be, you know, running also. You know, there's going to be more trash in the morning because it's not picked up. Again, Al, it's just not your place. It's going to touch every business on the beach, and they will all be able to stay open until 3 o'clock in the morning. And I just don't think, you know, that's the direction that we want to be heading towards. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Anybody else?
My name's Alex Brasso from 250 Woodland Road. I'm grew up in Hampton. I graduated Winnicott in 97. Faces are familiar around here. I used to go to the beach quite often when I was younger, and it was a little bit more seedy. Late 90s, a lot of partying, a lot of questionable acts that were being had. People were doing this all night long, leaving, driving up to Bickford's in Portsmouth, you know, right at the traffic circle, going to the Friendly Toast, driving quite intoxicated, doing, you know, just bad things. And it was something because there was no options available to just kind of sit. You go out in Portsmouth and you may have had a few too much. What do? You go to the Friendly Toast. You go to these establishments that are still open. You get a slice of pizza, you relax, you sit, you know, do what you need to do. Gives everybody a time to calm down. That's usually a good offer or a good option for these people. I've seen that happen. I've lived out in California for a long time. I was 10 years, and it was every single town I was in out there, it's a different environment, but had a late night option where they'd go, people would hang out, and it would be a calm transition from that rowdy exodus at 1 a.m. to 2:30. People are slowly making their way home, and everything's functioning at a much quieter level. And seeing that from experience, I feel that it's not a bad idea for our area. I've seen what he's done to the beach, and I know growing up, when I was down there when I was younger, when I came back, there was no way I'd go back to the beach. The beach was my childhood silliness. And what he's done has brought me, my family, back down there for food, entertainment, and I don't see this being a negative contribution to the beach after all the other positives. So that's all I have to say, but thank you.
Thank you.
So hi, my name is Tom Gaudet. I live at 10 Johnson Ave. So that 10 Johnson Ave is pretty much right behind Wally, so if you don't know. I bought the house 4 years ago. I sold my other house, and I moved there full-time this year. So I'm kind of new resident to the area, but I've been there enough to know what happens at Wally's. I really like Wally's, actually, sorry to say. It has really good food. Sorry. So I was listening to a lot of my neighbors talk, and I think they have some good arguments. But I do think there is a happy medium in various things. So I agree that if you grant one person the ability to do something, then other people are going to come along and try to do it as well. But I do think you can have certain rules put in place that allow Al to do it, because Al's done it in a certain way with his other establishments that really work. So I live behind there. And everybody's complaining about, oh, the noise at 1 o'clock or this or that. I bought the place. I knew what I was getting into before I bought it. But I really like the summertime here. That's why I bought the summer place. I really want to come and get to that atmosphere, the vacation place. But I also really love the beach, and I also live there, and I want to walk along the beach. And I love the winters when everybody goes home, right? Both are really good. But Al has really policed his properties in a proper way, right? He has people there making sure there aren't fights going on in my neighborhood. There aren't certain things going on, right? So you could allow somebody to have an establishment open for a couple more hours as long as they had certain guidelines to make sure there wasn't trouble, right? And I think that would stop other people from just opening up a little corner shop for 2 hours, right? You have to have some things in play there in order to allow to have the staff to do something like that, right? And only people who are really have the staff in that area could do something like that. So I think I am for it because I do believe I would prefer people to have a place to go where there is not alcohol, where they can calm down, where they can have something to eat before they drive home. But aside from that, I don't really see the negative. And I also don't see this being thousands and thousands of people, right? We all know the building we're talking about. It's not going to hold thousands and thousands of people, right? It's not like keeping Bernie's open until 5 a.m. It's a big difference, right? A lot of the arguments I heard were thinking, oh, we're going to keep Bernie's open with 1,000 people there till 5 a.m. You know, that's not what we're talking about. Anyway, that's my opinion. Thank you.
Thank you.
Pat Casey, 58 Exeter Road. Been on the beach since 2001. Seen the beach do tons of changes. And back in 2001, if you talk to a lot of people, Hampton Beach kind of wasn't a gem that it is now. A lot of people, if you said you were hanging out at Hampton Beach, you know, they'd be elsewhere. Janus Beach, North Beach, Seabrook. But what Al has done to the beach with the GOAT, updating Wally's, I mean, the place looks amazing. And then Bernie's alone. The talk up and down the seacoast from everyone that I talk to, they talk about Bernie's, they talk about the GOAT, they talk about Wally's, they talk about the things that Al has done. He has a vision that I haven't seen on the beach, on Hampton Beach since 2001. He builds things up. He creates things. He creates a buzz. He brings money into this town, and he brings a lot of money to a lot of people who live on the beach and have investment properties on the beach. So I think if Al wants to do this, I think it's a great opportunity for the beach, and he's going to do it right, just like the gentleman said before me. He's going to do it right. He's going to have people policing his property, and I think I'm all for it. I think Al's going to do a great job at it. Thank you.
Anybody else would like to give up and speak?
My name is Randall Durant. I live at 16 Susan Lane. And what I've been hearing tonight, I'm fully in support of what Al is proposing. But what I'm hearing overall sounds to me, by and large, that people are concerned about their little piece of the world being interrupted for whatever reason at 1 o'clock in the morning by a minority of people that may behave or may not, you know, but it's a minority of people that may behave in a bad fashion that may affect their piece of the world. I don't see that as happening collectively. There's problems at the beach, but it has nothing to do with Al serving a egg sandwich at 1:30 in the morning. There are people coming out of these areas that serve food to everybody all night long. Everybody here will be up there grabbing food and taking food from these staff people and tipping them out. And a valid point, he's trying to present something more in the way of commerce to give these people something when the beach does, you know, shut down at 1 a.m. Not everybody is out there drinking and being raucous. There are people that are with groups of people that don't drink at all. There are people coming in that have a reasonable expectation when they're at a hotel or a motel. Gee, I'm up here on vacation. I'd like to go out and get something to eat. Oh, I can't. I'm at Hampton Beach. I forgot. Everything's shut down. I think it's time to become somewhat consistent with the generation of which we live, which is people want to be afforded the convenience of being able to eat food and have the right to do so without a minority fraction of potential misbehaviors ruining it for the majority of people that basically all they want to do is eat at 1 or 2 o'clock in the morning when they're at a Hampton Beach for 100 days throughout the summer or nights. After that, the beach goes right back to being shut down virtually. But for 100 days and 100 nights, you live at the beach. You got to suck it up and deal. So what? You know, I mean, you chose to live here. Yeah, you know, they build raceways and racetracks. They have to build them somewhere. They don't build them away from where everybody can hear those racetracks. You know, you sign up when you buy a house at the beach for certain things to transpire when you're in that house. And that is, people are coming and going all summer long. And I believe that impeding this commerce for this particular, you know, non-alcohol related venture that Al is proposing, you know, it doesn't make sense to me. And lastly, the argument that everybody's going to want to do it, no. There aren't going to be Cisco trucks and U.S. food trucks parading up to the beach for 1,000 people that want to dump $300,000 into opening an eatery at Hampton Beach just so they can compete with Al at 3 o'clock in the morning. It's not going to happen. Thank you.
Thank you. Anybody else like to speak?
Hello, my name is Cambria Fisher. I live at 22 Anne's Lane. I've worked on the seacoast in Portsmouth and in Hampton for over 20 years. I've seen Gillies, how it goes up there. Yes, it's great. People go there, they eat. There is a little bit of problem sometimes, but I think that's because they don't have bouncers. It's a very tiny place. You put everybody in this like tiny little place that holds 8 people. That's why I think there's some problems there. But it is good because people do take the food. They go sit in the park, they eat, and then once they eat, they go home. They don't keep drinking. They don't, you know, keep staying out late. I think that would be good for the people who rent cottages. They could eat and go home. The people who want to keep drinking will leave the beach and go somewhere else and do it, or go back to their cottage with their food and relax and go inside and eat their food. And most of the time when people drink and then they eat, they go to bed. They're not ready to, like, keep going and keep partying. They eat and they're tired and they go to bed. So, Al's done wonderful things with the beaches. I think all of his places are amazing. All of his food is delicious. Yeah, I think he's going to do a really good job if you guys give him an opportunity. Thank you.
Helena Barthel, 33 Dover Avenue. It's been very informative here tonight, and I really can understand both opinions. For me personally, I don't live right there by one of the restaurants, but for me, I can kind of tell time, especially in the summer, after 1 o'clock and 1:30, because all the people leave Stacy Jane's and some of the other places, and they think they're going to come down to the dune and be out of sight and start shooting off fireworks and partying. So maybe it would actually help my sleep if this was open till 3 a.m, because I would get that much longer. But if the decision were up to me, I would like to know how is it working in Seabrook and Salisbury? I don't know, and I don't know the answers to these questions. Did they used to stop at one and then they extended it? What is their police activity? Is it more after 1 o'clock? You know, what kind of police activity do they have compared to Hampton from 1 to 3? Because do they see more crime? Do they see more trouble? And so if I were you making these decisions, I would, you know, I would just be curious, what do the police departments in Seabrook and Salisbury or Portsmouth, because those are the towns that we've, you know, they're comparing the ability to do this to, what those statistics are. And I also would like to know, like, would this apply to all restaurants, whether you serve alcohol or not? You know, would every restaurant be able to stay open? And, you know, maybe not serve alcohol, but to serve food. And I think there's just some unknowns for me to come and say I have a very strong opinion one way or the other. But I would just encourage the people who are making these decisions to look at not just people's opinions, which are very important, and everyone's counts, but to know what are the real statistics for crime, for prostitution increases, for drugs, for, you know, is it better or worse in that 1 to 3 o'clock hours compared to what Hampton has now? So thank you.
Are you for or against it? Because I'm keeping track here. And yes, all other restaurants would be able to be open.
I'm leaning towards the side of against it.
Okay, thank you.
But I'm not strong either way.
Thank you.
Is there anybody else who'd like to speak? Go ahead.
Joe Marion, 603 Ocean Boulevard. I'm somewhat new to Hampton, but about 10 years on the seacoast.
Speak up, please.
About 10 years on the seacoast, somewhat new to Hampton. I don't see anything detrimental about this. I would encourage it to be able to have food as somebody who does work in this industry, not on the beach anymore, but I did, and to be able to get a decent meal after work and to have people who have been consuming perhaps excessively to sit down and have hopefully caffeinated beverages and food before they wander on their way seems nothing but wonderful. And for other business to be able to do that in a responsible manner also seems like a direction that you would want to go to as a destination, as a resort community for people to come and be able to get what they want at a later time. I see nothing, I mean, I understand and I agree that, you know, but if you live here, like I chose to live at the beach. And if you roll to the left while everybody else is at work during the day when all the traffic is when I'm trying to sleep. So, I mean, you pick where you live. And I want to live at the beach. So, I'm for it.
Thank you. Anybody else would like to speak?
Alex Wazzo, 47 Ocean Boulevard. I've been a lifelong Hampton resident. My parents owned businesses on this beach my entire life, convenience stores when I was growing up. Now I'm a business owner down in Hampton Beach, and I'm kind of looking at it from the business perspective in that a lot of people look at us in the beach and they see all the people down there in the summer months, and you know everyone thinks everyone's making a killing. They don't see we have 3 months. We have a short season. It's almost 10 weeks to make our money, that kind of thing. You know, so I feel like if we want to be a beach destination, we all look at the beach and we want people to be putting money into their properties and that kind of thing. And in the last 10 years, it's been fantastic. Between the state redevelopment, I mean, you just drive down the beach, so many things have changed. The boardwalk, you know, Chuck Rage is done, Tom McGuirk at McGuirk's, you just see all that. And to get us to be able to put that investment into the beach, we kind of have to embrace the business community and what we're trying to do. So I would say, at least if we were going to do this, I'm in support of it, to give it a shot, because I mean, if we want to become the beach destination, you know, I mean, we already are East Coast, you know, we're a huge beach destination. In order to continue to keep growing that, I feel like we have to expand, keep trying new things. And as everyone has already said, pretty much everyone around us has that. I mean, if I go to vacation in Florida, I mean, there's families down there and that kind of thing, but they have the late night options and that kind of thing. And even myself, if I'm in the office till midnight, you know, typically this time of year, I'm in the office 6 a.m. till midnight. When I got to work, I really don't want to go home and cook for myself. It'd be nice to have an option in town, you know, then going to the gas station, grabbing a bag of chips, that kind of thing. You know, just, you know, being down here. I work down here. I live down here. So I'm in full support of it. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Anybody else would like to speak?
Michelle Milliken, I have a property at 6 Ashworth Ave, and I am 100% for this. I think it's a wonderful opportunity to give people a chance to, after being out drinking and partying all night, to have a chance to collect themselves, pull themselves together, and I think it would be safer for the community to have them have that option, to have that late night food option. I support Al 100%.
Anybody else? A room full of people, if anybody wants to.
Brian Provencial, 12 Fuller Acres, Hampton Beach. I literally just got back from Key West 2 hours ago.
Can't tell.
Um, I'm for this. I own a business right next door to Al. I own the pier. It's a restaurant. And I almost feel like it's, we're doing a disservice to our people that come here. A lot of people, you get, I worked for Al for a long time before that. 1 o'clock comes around and you go, hey, you got to finish it up. You got to go. I got to take your drink. You take your drink. You send them out the door and they're like, all right. They drink it real fast and they go outside and then they go, all right, I need to get something to eat. And there's someone standing there going, you got to go home now. You can't, beach is closed. And they're like, what? And they're like, you want me to get in the car and drive now? Yeah, you got to get in the car and you have to drive now. I think that there's, they should have an option. I think there should be some place you can go get something to eat. I don't know how late, but I mean, even an hour, letting somebody collect themselves, have something to drink, and eating will not sober you up, you're correct, but time will. That's the only thing that's going to do that. So if you get a chance to sit down, eat a cheeseburger, there's a lot of people that come to my place at 12:15 and I'm making them cheeseburgers, and then there's still a line of people that want food, and I have to go, no, you can't have any food. But we don't want a drink, we just want something to eat. Can you just make me some clams? I go, I can't. It's 1 o'clock, beach is closed, you got to go home. I think it'd be great if someone had a chance to go and grab something to eat. I think, you know, your hands aren't tied, as far as John said. It is an issue if all the boardwalk opens up, because they're going to want to, and you're going to have to let them. People are going to have to go to the bathroom somewhere. There's nowhere for them to go to the bathroom. So if you want to stay open past those hours, you should have to have the facilities for people to relieve themselves, because that is going to be an issue. There'll be 100 people up there trying to get sausages with nowhere to go to the bathroom, and you know they're going to go somewhere. That would happen. Other than that, I don't know. It's up to you guys. Thank you.
Thank you. Anybody else would like to get up and speak? The other Mr. Preston.
Charlie Preston, 47 Glade Path. I heard a couple of things tonight. I really don't have much of a feeling either way on it. I see both sides. I see if you allow for one, you've got to allow for all. I think something that might be able to be considered is if this was inside a structure and there was no noise emanating from that structure. I think that takes out the noise part. And I think it also takes out the fact that every other place could do it because it's inside and it's not. And now as far as controlling the noise, that's where the chief would come in. Because I'd want to have him weigh in on it, because, you know, a detail might be required to be out in front of an establishment to make sure that quiet is kept. But that's just something to consider, you know, so it doesn't get to be every place that wants to be open. Thank you.
Thank you.
So you for or against, Charlie?
I really don't have a feeling either way, right? I'm just, what I'm saying is it's if there's no noise emanating, you can all understand noise. We can understand that. You know, we can also understand every other business wanting to be open. Now, if you had every business on the strip that's open, it's going to go around the block. If it's inside, you can kind of control an environment if there's no noise emanating from the place. And you guys gave some considerations to the chief to say, how do we or can we? You know, I'd be interested to hear the chief on that. Thank you.
Anybody else from the public? Now's your chance. I knew I'd get you up.
Yeah, thanks. Jason Vaughn, 158 Ashworth Ave. I work on the beach. On the weekends, I bartend and I bounce, and I work for Al Fleury. But I, too, get up at 4 in the morning every single day. I've been going since 4. As you can see, I'm still in my gross work clothes. I think it's a huge benefit for the beach. People leaving the bars drunk, it's got a place to eat. Work until 1:30, 2 in the morning when I'm up at 4. It's a 22-hour day. I would love to go have a nice sandwich when I get out of work instead of going home and making ramen noodles. So just allowing a place for people to go to and settle down instead of driving to Portsmouth, getting a DUI, everyone having a mass exodus at 1:30. How many cars do you pull over a night at 1:30? A lot, probably. You know, it's now you're going to break up the night and people aren't going to leave all at once. I think it might make the job a little bit easier in the end, so I'm for it. I think it's a great idea.
Thank you. Anybody else? Well, does anybody else want to get up before she comes up again for the second time? Guess you're okay.
Pam Panarelli, 25 K Street. I know you're saying that the noise inside is going to be quiet, but when they leave, you can't control that. That's the issue. And I've owned restaurants. I know how it works. I know Al feeds his, I'm sure Al feeds his cut her his employees before they leave. They all probably get food. You guys never eat at the restaurant?
No, not at 2 in the morning.
Not at 2 in the morning. There's no kitchen staff. They're closed. Kitchen closes at midnight. There's no kitchen staff to cook food out when we're done.
And nobody has food at home. I mean,
let's not have some back and forth. Let's.
Yeah. I mean, I just want you to see my point of view. I think it's awesome that all else family or employees and friends came out. I mean, I think that's awesome that you're supporting him. I support him. I think he's a great guy. But you know, our houses are 2 feet away from each other, and it's going to be loud, and it's going to be a nuisance. And I knew buying at my property at 1 o'clock, it was at least going to end. I don't want it till 5 o'clock in the morning. I didn't sign up for that. That's not fair. That's not fair. We already, you know, I bought it at one particular point, and now you're saying, oh, no, we changed our mind. Everything that we worked so hard for, you want to change for 3 hours. You're saying 60 people, but if 10 places open up, you're talking, you know, a lot more people. It's not just 60 people at Al's. And it would be an awesome place, and I'd probably go. But I don't want the people throwing up in my flower beds and urinating on my neighbor's yards. I mean, it's ridiculous. And you can't control that. And I don't think it's the police. I mean, I don't think we have that. They have enough staff to worry about doing that as well. I think they have more important things to do than that. That's all I have to say.
Just one moment. Someone old coming back.
I just want to say this. I admire the loyalty of all the people who work for him coming to support him. It's a tribute to you. However, another thing that I heard was we're going to have all the people that are going to drink at Wally's or the other establishments, and then we're going to feed them an egg sandwich, and they're going to be fine, and they're going to drive the car home. We all know that doesn't work. It's kind of unrealistic.
Well, doubling around. Do you have a report from the chief as to his advice for this?
He hasn't got up and spoke yet, so.
Okay.
Two times around.
I'm sorry. I just, being on the budget committee, I know there's a report somewhere.
So, is there anybody? Go ahead, Mr. Provencia.
I don't think that everybody down there would be opening up and doing it. Right now, there is one place down there, I don't know if this board knows, that can do it, and they choose not to. They don't need any permission from you. They're in a general zone. And if you were wanting to go uptown, you could open up a 24-hour place. That's not against any ordinance either. So this is just down at the beach. So Uda's. Uda's is in a general zone. The luncheonette there?
Well, now you got Uda coming up, so.
Uda Pino, 15 Tuttle Ave. Yes, I can be open 24 hours, and I choose not to. I do have neighbors. I don't care what Al does, but I have a couple questions, and I'm really confused. Okay. On one hand, you guys say, my help doesn't eat. Wait a second, there's a labor law. They have breaks, they have eating times. Make them a sandwich. Give them a pretzel or something, I don't care what. They're supposed to eat or go out and get something. Then you guys saying, when they can leave the bar room and they're drunk, an egg sandwich or a hamburger is not gonna sober you up. No way. I don't care what you do, personally. I don't care if you're open, not open, or not. It doesn't bother me. So nobody can say I'm jealous. I'm not jealous. I dealt with drunks in the morning. When I first opened up, I let them in. By 5 o'clock, I was so pissed off. And I took it out on other customers because of the drunks. It's not fair. So I don't know what your plans are. If you close at 3 o'clock and when you're going to reopen in the morning at 5, come down for 2 hours or you're staying open?
No, it would just be... Can I talk back? Can we answer? We try to feed people, obviously. You know,
And the idea isn't the cheeseburger is going to sober you up. The time afterwards is going to give you the time. Has anybody here tried to get a taxi or an Uber in Hampton Beach ever? I'm sure, the chief can attest. It's absolutely impossible. I hope that this year it will be better, but it's impossible. It gives people the opportunity to sit, that gives them that time while they eat, while they have a coffee, to choose whether or not to drive home. Maybe it's not sobering you up, but you can call for a ride, pray that we find some way that this town can get a taxi service that actually picks you up and gets you home safely, or you get an Uber, you work it out, but it gives you time, and time does sober you up. And what I would
it
do...
It takes more than an hour.
Or maybe not there. Too. Well, trust it depends me. When you stop drinking. And I've been there too. I was probably one of the drunk people that came at 5 in the morning to your place.
No,
maybe
it
once.
It used to be long before you came around.
What do you do with the ones that come at 5 o'clock in the morning now? What do you do with the people that come at 5 o'clock in the morning now that are still drunk?
I try to ignore them. I turn on classical music, and that usually drives them out. All right? I can put Oompa Ba Band in classical music. It works. They don't hang around. But I do every once in a while, I do get drunks, and I get busload of drunks when they come from upstate New York, Pennsylvania, New Jersey, wherever else they come up to go out fishing. They charter a bus, they come down, and it happens, the bus pulls up, the door opens up, and there come the beer cans. And I'm going, okay, I'm standing right by the door. As soon as they come off, I go right back on there, you're not coming in here. I don't want that. And it changes the base of your customers. You have that older couple sitting in there at 5 o'clock in the morning. They don't want to listen to a bunch of drunks.
So what I would be looking towards doing a later, I'm the opposite end of the world. So when every kitchen in Hampton Beach closes at 10, I want to open at 10.
I understand that, Al.
Yeah. So
I'm just saying I don't care what you do.
Okay.
I'm not against it. I'm not for it. Okay. But when he said there's one place on the beach I can do it,
no, I saw that happening.
No, but what I was trying to say, obviously, what I was saying is if it goes through, not everybody's going to choose to do it. That's what I was.
I don't want to.
No, I know you don't, but there's other people that don't.
I've been down there. This is my 28th year, and before that I worked at Elstree Tavern, and before that I worked at the Galley Hatch. I did my time. You know, go up to the truck stop at 20 up in Greenland.
I've done this.
But it's just when you bring my name into No, I mean whatever you're gonna do, I wish you good luck. I'm not for it, I'm not against it. I just don't want it. End of the story.
Yeah.
Two-way brag, Ab. Just for the record, every kitchen employee gets a meal. Al doesn't even charge them if you work in the kitchen. But they can't get a hot meal at 1:30. The kitchen closes at 11. We go to a late night menu. They get something in a to-go box is their only option. Now you're eating something cold instead of something freshly made. That was the point. But we do feed all the cooks and all the dishwashers and all the people that work in the kitchen. Thanks.
So anybody else would like to speak?
The liquor law says, Tom, you're supposed to serve till 12:30, till last call. Better check it out.
It's not true.
Oh, yes.
Can I ask a question?
Sure.
How would you control people that are going to stand outside smoking? Like at all the other places that are open now, it seems to be a big problem.
I would be willing to entertain, again, I just came forward to think that I think it's a great idea for the beach. And I'm sure the chief can attest, anytime, whether it's, if there was a detail asked of me, I've never refused it. I've even called and asked for them myself. There's always police officers outside of Wally's, 10-ish every night. And I'm happy to see them. It helps people dissipate. If there are people smoking outside, I mean, the general rule of thumb, I mean, it's very hard to control what happens on the sidewalk. Like, the response I usually get is that I don't own the sidewalk. I mean, you just kind of try to, you know, be as amiable to people as you can and hope that they are back. And, I mean, I don't have this, you know, I'm sure there's horror stories, but a lot of the people that I've heard talk, and for the record, not all these people work for me. And the ones that do, they pay taxes too, and they're citizens too, and they live uptown. It, just because they work in the restaurant industry doesn't, their loyalty to me, that means that they have to talk. There was no torture done before this meeting to get people to come here. But, I mean, the smoking, I'm not sure, just as any other restaurant. I mean, I like the idea of everything being confined, what Charlie said, but I don't know if that's more because I know how to control that kind of thing. And even at Bernie's, where we're not confined, it's easy to confine because it's up in the air and there's glass and everything. The smoking is definitely something I'd hear out. I mean, obviously smoking wouldn't be allowed indoors, so I would assume they would just smoke as they left. Or you could let them in, I guess, and in, and then you don't leave until you go.
Anybody else want to speak?
I don't want to speak, but I guess I have to. Wow. What an eclectic group we have with different opinions on this. When I read about this, I did have some concerns. Some of the messages that were being put out there were just inaccurate about how dealing with people that are intoxicated work. I'm glad to hear many of the people understand, because I was worried about some of our folks that are selling alcohol, understand that eating after you drink does not sober you up. Drinking coffee after you're drunk doesn't sober you up. It makes you a more awake drunk or a drunk with a full belly. It does not have any effect on your intoxication level. That food has to be in your stomach before you consume the alcohol to slow the absorption rate. It doesn't eliminate it, it slows it down. Okay? So I'm glad that some of those things have been debunked here tonight. We don't have to belabor that. My issues with, first I want to address the legality of the ordinance. I believe the ordinance is legal. I know we're going to have Attorney Gerald look at that. But part of the thing that has been left out of the discussion is we cited RSA 105 as the driving force. Our ordinance also says, or any other applicable state statute. It's a catch-all. There are, I believe, enabling statutes that allow this board to enact limitations on business in this community. So I believe that the ordinance is going to be legal. But I think that's probably a further discussion with Mark and legal counsel on that. To address whether this is a good idea, I understand other communities have it. But if you talk to the police up in Portsmouth, they're not big fans of those late night places because they have constant problems there. You just have to Google that establishment, Gillies, and you'll see some of the famous altercations that have occurred there, or at Bickford's when we had a brawl that caused 10 towns to respond in the state police. So is it a nightly occurrence? No, I can't say that it is. But if you read the Portsmouth Police Log, there is a frequency of calls to that establishment after 1 a.m. And that's what we're really talking about. We've grown up here. I've been on Hampton Beach since 1979, living and working. My family was in business down there. So I think I have a pretty good idea of how things work down there. We all grew up with that 1 a.m. It was time to go. The bars were closed and there was no food down here. And you drove to Gillies and you drove to Salisbury Beach. Many people have been honest here. They've highlighted that many of the people doing that were intoxicated when they did it. What makes anybody believe that if we open it up, people that are intoxicated in other communities aren't going to do the same thing coming to Hampton? The guarantee is, if this is permitted to happen, whether it's Mr. Flores' establishment or other in other establishments, will follow. If anybody doesn't think that's going to happen, they're being naive. If it's an opportunity to make money on Hampton Beach, people are going to do it. That's just good business. But that will continue to draw people at that hour of night. And unfortunately, at that hour of night, yes, there are people that aren't drinking. There are people that are out causing trouble. But statistically, you'll see that when we make arrests, the number of people that are impaired by alcohol goes up substantially after about 11 o'clock at night till about 3 o'clock in the morning. Okay? When you look at our statistics, I can't speak to Portsmouth or anybody else's. I can certainly do some research for the board if that's what they wish. But when you look at the statistics of the Hampton Police Department in our summer operation, they start dipping, the calls for service stop dipping dramatically after 2 a.m. Now, the vast majority of our part-time officers that we augment within the summer that come in and help maintain order down at the beach, they work a 6 p.m. to 2 a.m. shift. If this were to be allowed, it would have a significant impact in our scheduling. Quite frankly, it's going to drive our overtime through the roof because those officers that work the 6 to 2 have other jobs to go to. They don't just work for Hampton PD. They have regular jobs that they have to get up in the morning and go to work. If I now have to extend them or alter those shifts to 3 a.m., 4 a.m., that's going to cause a problem. And we already are challenged by recruitment and bringing officers into the police department. I don't know if the board got word that I don't know how much I'm going to be able to count on the state police this year. There was a move afoot at one of the financial committees that oversees their budget to eliminate the budget for the state police details at Hampton Beach.
Is that this year?
Now, it's early in the budgeting process, but the mere fact they're even talking about that is scary. Okay? Add on top, a week from tomorrow, we go to town meeting, and we have a budget containing funding for the police department. If that were to fail, that's going to have a significant impact on my operations. Whether this happens or not, if this happens, it's going to be detrimental to our operation. It is going to cause an impact on our ability to provide for public safety. Now, the issue of time is good to allow people to sober up. The first thing I would say that if you're operating a licensed liquor establishment on Hampton Beach, I think I've been very clear that my number one goal when I took over as chief was to curb the over-serving. This is not a good direction to go if we're trying to curb over-serving, because this is just going to enable it. They'll be fine. They'll go someplace to sober up before they get behind the wheel. That's just a bad, bad methodology in my mind to operate down there. We're trying to curb the over-serving of alcohol down there. And instead of curbing it, we're going to find a place for them to go to sober up. I can't go along with that. I can't support that. Statistically, I had my prosecution department take a look at statistics for the summer of 15 and 16. For DWI arrests made in Hampton during June, July, and August of those 2 years, from 1 a.m. to 7 a.m., the average BAC of somebody that submitted to the breath test was a 0.13. Now, the average burn-off rate, scientifically, we know is a 0.016. So if somebody were to have their last drink at any establishment in Hampton or coming in from another town, and they were 0.13 at 1 o'clock, they would wind up being, based on that formula, a 0.114 at 2 a.m. and a 0.098 at 3 a.m., both over the legal limits under the laws of the state of New Hampshire. So this time issue, yes, I agree, time is good. If you could get them to sit in that establishment for 4 to 5 hours, then it might work. But based on what's being proposed, you're going to give people the false sense that they're okay to drive. Have my last drink, go have a hamburger, have a drink, you know, a coffee, whatever, and I'm good to go. Statistically, no, you're not. You're still over the legal limit. So based on those issues, I can't support this proposal.
Okay. Well, I've asked a number of times if anybody wanted to speak, and we've had a number of people that have got up and spoke twice. I said at the point that when I started this, we were going to recess this hearing. I was going to give people allow a week or so to send in anything that they wanted to do. It'll also, some points have been brought up here, or some very good points, and I think we're going to have the police chief probably get some more information as to what's going on in Seabrook or Salisbury when this happened and stuff. So we've got some legal questions that we want to hear back from our town attorney. And so we will keep it open for tomorrow. We'll see until next Monday. That'll give them, if somebody wants to send something in, and then over the next week after that, we will look at it, and then we will bring it back on the 21st March 20th. We will follow up then on the 20th for this. I want to thank everybody for coming in and speaking. I know it's been a hot topic. I know we needed to get it done, but I think it's important that we have public hearings like this. And again, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Very fair.
Thank you for all the time.
Thank you.